So we are back with the random episode of the Madden NFL 17 franchise mode, and today we have a huge match between the Cleveland Browns and the San Francisco 49ers here in Cleveland. So this matchup basically marks the first time that Keifer Paup and Cole Colvin, the first and third overall picks in the 2016 NFL draft, facing off each other for the first time in franchise history, at least in their entire careers. So huge matchup obviously today. This will decide, I guess, who's the better quarterback so far throughout their entire career and so on. So I'm gonna start off the kickoff return by a returner, I believe it's Allen, for I believe a 30-yard return. They set up at the 30. And we do have Keifer Paup here coming on today for the first time. He's 7 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, 1,143 yards passing so far this season. A completion percentage over 70% so far. So he's having a very good season so far. The Browns. But now second and 4, ball in the 37. As he delivered a pass right to Corey Coleman there for a first down on the day. So the first pass, first down for today for Keifer Paup and the offense. So Corey Coleman, I want to get him involved as much as I want today, as I can today, because he's a great wide receiver. But I get to deliver a pass right there to our tight end Urbick for a first down on first and 10. So getting a decent drive set up today, back-to-back first downs on both plays. We got to use Urbick, Corey Coleman. Just their entire receiving corps is amazing so far, but there's our offensive line built in that same draft class we drafted Cole Colvin. I mean, the 49ers drafted Cole Colvin, we drafted Keifer Paup. So great draft class, the offensive line, the quarterbacks. I mean, it's got everything. But they're passed there on 3rd and 10 to Malcolm Gilmore, but he cannot hold on there. It's going to end up being 4th down. So all these drops led to a field goal. So now we're leading 3-0 here in this game as Cole Colvin's coming on the field today for the first time against these Browns, as he's having a decent season so far. 5 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. Plus you can see that flow, that golden locks he has. In his player card though, he's bald in the in-game, but on this game for some reason he's actually has hair. So it's pretty weird to see that for Cole Colvin. But first today, he's going to get a rush there, 9-yard gain there in that first play. Now first and 10, he delivered a rush right there to the running back once again. Gets a few yards on that one and sets up on 2nd and 3, ball in the 47. So our defensive line, it's pretty good, but now 3rd and 2 here, ball in the 40-yard line here. As another rush there to Gatewood. Gatewood just crushes through defense there for a first down on that play. So Gatewood, already 5 rushes, 29 yards in this drive, so he's having a great drive so far for him. And now 2nd and 7, deliver pass right through to the wide receiver for close to a first down, maybe even a first down, but it's 3rd and inches. So 3rd and inches, ball in 24, as they give a fake handoff to the running back, but he goes and gets a rush, I believe, of 10 yards on that fake. So Cole Colvin using his legs there a bit, a rush of 9 yards on that one for a first down on that rush. So on the 15-yard line here on 2nd and 10, deliver pass to the wide receiver. The wide receiver almost in the end zone there, but we tackle him on the 1. That's 1st and goal. They drop back, but Cole Colvin gets hammered by our defensive line, and we get the sack with Jordan Grayson and another linebacker getting in on that sack. So Jordan Grayson, another great linebacker we drafted in our franchise mode. He gets the Cole Colvin there on his blind side. You gotta love those blindside hits though. I love seeing that in game. Just it's cool to see that. But now, second goal here, ball on the 4, deliver rush there to Gatewood. Gatewood crushes through our defensive line once again and gets a touchdown. So now they're leading 7-0 here, or 7-3 here in this game, as we gotta go and now come back from the 49ers winning in this game, which kind of sucks, I guess. But Gatewood, he's a beast though. I didn't think he'd play this well for their team, I guess, as the 49ers are one of the worst teams in the NFL, at least looking at their team-wise, but they're 2-2 in the season, so not that bad, I guess. Now 3rd and 12, your ball on the 20, another pass it right to our wide receiver, but we do not get enough, and that's going to end up setting up us at 4th and 4. So we get to go and punt here, a Sam Martin punt. He delivers a booming kick there right to the 15-yard line here, and we're going to go and let a kick return get us up to the 30, as they go and shoot off one tackle, a fake, and that's going to get them to the 40-yard line there, 39, after a great return there by the returner. So a 23-yard return off that punt, a great punt though by Sam Martin, delivering them in the corner. But now first 10-yard ball in the 39, deliver a rush to Gatewood once again, but he gets caught near the backfield, I guess. He gets just enough of a rush to make it 2nd and 8. So now 38 here, ball on the 42. A play action right to the running back as Cole Colvin drops back. He's going to find nobody as he gets hammered from behind for a sack. But there's a penalty flag on the field. Let's see if this is against us. And it looks like it's not against us. That's against the offense. And we're going to decline that one and make it 4th and 10 off that sack by Courtney Upshaw. So our defensive line playing so well, or defense in general playing well. But it's now 2nd and 6 here, ball on the 24. Delivered pass to reach Corey Coleman. Coleman gets just enough for a first down. Finally, so he finally get a first down ever since that first drive, and now he can start getting some stuff going here to try and get a lead in this game. And now first 10-yard ball in the 33, throw a pass once again our wide receiver Kenny Stills are checking in there for close to a first down on that one. So Kenny Stills, I mean, he's a beast when you check him in there to the offense. He's got enough speed to him that he just a big play kind of guy, you know. Diller passed him, you know he's going to get at least 10 yards out using that speed. But now for his 10-yard ball in the 44, Diller passed deep down the field to Rolon Amorosa, and he's heading to the house. Touchdown, Browns. So, a touchdown by Rolon Amorosa, our speedy wide receiver off the corner. A 44-yard touchdown makes it 10-7 here in the second quarter. So, exactly what you want, a big play kind of guy. And his name is Rolon Amorosa. Obviously, we did draft him in the fifth round, the same draft as Keifer Paup and half our offensive lineman was from. So, now second and 10-yard ball in the 25 as Cole Colvin drops back. He's got nowhere to go, and he gets sacked by Emmanuel Ogba as he gets to the quarterback. Make it third and 23. So, Ogba, Cordy Upshaw, Jordan Grayson, everyone playing so well in this game. We get every time I go and play at one of these games, we usually get tons of sacks, at least 5 or 6 every single game. So it's crazy to see that, just hammering quarterbacks left and right. Is our defense. Our defense, one of the top defenses in the NFL so far this year, so I'm pretty proud of that one. But now 4th and 23, they punt this one deep down the field there, the 25 in fact, as we go get a return, as Odom gets around the right side edge here. Odom runs out of bounds there at the 44 on their side of the field, so great return there by Samuel Odom. He's got the 96 speed, you gotta love that, a returner, Baz. So we set up a drive at 2nd and 10 yard ball on the 44 yard line here for the Browns offense, as Keifer Paup's gonna drop back all time in the world, deliver pass to Rolon Amorosa for a first down on that first play the drive. So you got the touchdown last time, as now it's 3rd and 5, your ball in the 27. We drop back but throw an interception right to our former linebacker Demario Davis. So Demario Davis gets revenge against his Browns, as I forgot we even had Demario Davis on the 49ers in this franchise mode. I'm pretty surprised they signed them. But now first tenure on the 24 is a little passage to the one of the wide receivers for a first down. So this 49ers offense kind of spotty, I guess. Sometimes they get plays, successful plays down the field and get a good drive going. But now 3rd and 11, your ball in the 35. As they go and get dropped back, but get hammered by Raheem Sr. and Emmanuel Ogba, as they both come together to make a Cole Colvin sandwich. So, if you look at the replay in here, just from the left and the right, and bam, Cole Colvin sandwich made, prepared for the offense. So, you gotta love this, our defense playing so well against these 49ers, who have a great quarterback though, because Cole Colvin, he's 89 overall, he's a great quarterback, but the problem is the rest of the offense just isn't as good as he is, as they deliver a boomerang kick right down the field to Odom, as Odom gets around the left side edge, as Odom gets a huge return on that play to deliver to once again at the 47-yard line there. So a great play there by Samuel Odom. As we sit up there, ball in the 46 here, 2nd and 12, as Keifer Paup's good drop back here. He's going to find a man open there in Corey Coleman for close to the first down there on that play. So Corey Coleman, he's a big play kind of guy, but out there in 2, ball in the 45, Diller passes to Rolon Amorosa, but Amorosa drops that one, and that makes it 4th down on this drive. So our drives just not being complete at all, as we're going to go for it in 4th and 2 here, as we drop back and find a man open in Scott Urbick, or Joseph Fourier in fact, and he gets in bounds there for a first down. So we get close to the first down there, we get a first down there on that play, after getting just as many yards as we needed to on that one. But now 2nd and 4-yard ball on the 36 of play action right to Duke, as Diller passes to our fullback Vince Hanks, and he gets a first down, a first 10-yard ball on the 23-yard line here for the Browns with 21 seconds left in the half. It's delivered a screen pass right to Duke Johnson gets a first down there with that screen pass. Only 14 seconds left in the half to deliver timeout there and try and go for it all here on 2nd and 10, ball in 11, as dropback fan man open there in the end zone for a touchdown. So Rolon Amorosa breaks the plane once again, and then we make it a 17-7 game here heading into halftime. So great pass there by Keifer Paup. Almost no time in the world as he just levers it right in the end zone to our speedy wide receiver, Rolon Amorosa. So we're getting off the half here, 17-7 score. As you go into the second half, you're trying to go and shut down these 49ers and take this W. So great first half there by the defense and the offense, in fact, too. Putting up 17 points in the first half is not too bad against the 49ers, as they go for the screen pass here to start off the second half, but really unsuccessful as we get in the backfield for the tackle for a loss. So 2nd and 17 there, a 7-yard loss off that crappy screenplay set up by the 49ers. But now 3rd and 17, your ball is 18-yard line here. They drop back. They deliver deep down the field there for the catch, and he's gonna go down the field as he sheds off one tackle. Amaro going into the end zone, the 10, the 5, touchdown 49ers. So a huge play there by the 49ers on 3rd and 17, as they got so lucky on that play though. I don't know how we couldn't deliver the tackle as they break the plane for a touchdown. So the 49ers get so lucky on that play, and that makes it, I believe, a 17-14 game here, a 3-point game for us, as we get the offensive possession once again, trying to go and score another touchdown with the offense. But now first 10-yard ball in the 34, it's gonna drop back and find a man open there in Joseph Fourier once again, I guess, as he gets around the edge for close to first down, if not second and inches. So second inches here, ball to 44, now third inches here. As you'll have the rest there to Duke Johnson. Duke Johnson gets up the middle there for another first down once again. So just only 3 yard rushes, 14 yards so far in this game. Our rushing game not as strong as it should be here, as a third 16-yard ball to 42. So they drop back there and find a man open there in Corey Coleman. Coleman gets a block, and he's getting out of bounds. He gets hammered. And finally we go and get a huge play there for a first down. So Corey Coleman, 15 yards run after the catch in that one, as he uses speed tremendously on that play to get that first down. But you gotta see though, that block is so key though. I love whenever the wide receivers finally block for me, because usually just doesn't really happen for me, I guess, in this game. As now first in your ball on the 34, as a good drop back, trying to roll to the right, but we get sacked for a loss. So we try to go deliver that pass there in open time, but you cannot, as that's now 3rd and 18, ball in the 42, deliver pass it right to Foria or Urbic once again there, and we get just a few yards in that one and make it 4th and 11. So Keifer Paup so far, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception so far on the day. Not too bad of a game so far. It's now 2nd and 10, your ball on the 25, another screen pass there by the 49ers, and that's I guess a few yards in that one, which makes it 3rd and 5, ball in the 30. So you do a rush there once again to the running back, but Gatewood is not successful as last time, as he gets hammered in the backfield for a loss. Enough, 4th and 6 here, they're forced to punt. It's a booming punt though to the 30-yard line here, and once again, a Samuel Odom. Odom gets around the right side edge once again with the speed, as Odom cannot figure out the last guy, and he delivers to the 44-yard line here once again after a great punt return by him once again. So now it's 1st and 10-yard ball on the 44. Deliver rush to Duke Johnson there on the left side, as he gets hammered out of bounds there, and I believe he got the first down in time, and he did not, as it's now 2nd and 10. But now 1st and 10-yard ball on the 30-yard line here. Deliver rush to Duke on the right side, and Duke finally getting some space. He gets hammered out of bounds once again there, and now it's only 7 rushes, 46 yards so far on the day, as now 2nd and 2, ball on the 10-yard line here. Another screen pass there by the Browns, and we finally get the blocks we need and run into the end zone for a touchdown. So Mark Ingram breaks the play in there, as it looks like Keifer Paup does semi-Tebow there after his 10th touchdown pass of the season. So a great screen pass there. Mark Ingram checks in, and he uses speed and his, I guess, the blockers to get in the end zone for the touchdown, which makes it 27-14 here, a 13-point game for the Browns, as I believe the 49ers are now 33 or ball in 32, as they get dropped back once again. They find a man open just enough for a first down after that fake and that tackle. So now it's 1st and 10-yard ball on the 41, as another rush to Gatewood here. Gatewood cannot figure the last guy, but gets pounds there through for a first down. But now it's 1st and 10-yard ball on the 48, another pass to one of their wide receivers. They break the plane once again and get a first down once again. So they're getting first downs left and right, trying to aggressively get down the field here, as they get the ball to Gatewood once again here, and he gets just enough there for, guess what, another first down on this drive. So it's 1st and 10-yard ball on the 24, as look at this possession though. 2, 3, 4. Look how much time he is in the pocket here, as Cole Colvin, they drop back. He get intercepted by Eli Apple. So all the time in the world for the pocket. I believe he had like 8 or 9 seconds in the pocket, but did not find a man open, and he just delivers an interception right there to Eli Apple on that one. So Apple, I mean, you gotta love that though. His hands is sticky on that one, those gloves, and gets the interception. So we get the ball back here on offense here. Now 2nd and 9, your ball on the 23. So they drop back here and get sacked by the 49ers. We cannot find a man open there for the pass. So Brown gets this once again for the second sack of the game for them. As now 3rd and 20, your ball on the 13. We got to deliver a pass deep down the field, as we're going to find a man deep down the field once again in Roland Marbarosa, but he cannot hold on for the catch. So close. We could have got a huge play there by Marbarosa, but now it's 4th and 20 here as they're forced to punt. So it's 1st and 10-yard ball on the 47 for the 49ers, as we almost get the sack, but they deliver a pass there down the field for a first down, a huge first down there for them as they break the other side of the field. Now they're on the other side of the field, our side of the field for the offense. But now 1st and 10-yard ball on the 32. It's going to drop back once again. You're all the time in the world once again for the offensive line. Just playing so well for Cole Colvin. As they're a short pass there for only, I guess, a -1 yard on that one. So it's now 2nd and 11, your ball on the 33. Drop back once again and find a man open and gets close to a first down there on that play. So that makes it 3rd down here with only inches to go here for the first down. So they're trying to go and get a touchdown here in the late minutes of the fourth, as now they deliver a pass there down the field for a first down. They finally break into the red zone here once again on the day. So the 49ers, they're actually getting pretty aggressive at this point in the game. They're trying to go and force us to go and give up some points here, as they give it to passer right to Gatewood. Gatewood rushes into the end zone there for a touchdown. So Gatewood, another touchdown in the game, his second rushing touchdown of the game. Makes it 27-20 points game here in the fourth, as now it's 27-21 in the fourth. So now second and 2 here, ball on the 29. Another passer right to Duke Johnson there for a few yards. I believe 9 yards on that play for close to first down. And a third 5 here, ball on the 47. Another passer to Urbick, but Urbick gets close to first down on that play. So close, but it's 4th and 1. And you know what we usually do on 4th and 1, we go for it all because we're the Browns. And Keifer Paup gets more than one on that one as he gets a first down on that QB sneak. So it's a new set of downs here for us, our offense. And now first 10-yard ball on the 3rd 46. Another rush there to Duke Johnson. Duke Johnson gets the blocks. He's going down the field to 10, the 5, and he gets into the end zone for a touchdown. So a huge play by Duke Johnson. Makes it a huge point lead for us, as we need that 33-21 game. No, it's soon to be 34-21 after a great rush by Duke Johnson. Even better blocking job by our offensive line. So you gotta love that though. The blocking was key, the running was just amazing, as we finally break in the end zone for a rushing touchdown on the day. So now it makes it 34-21 here. Another screen pass there by the 49ers, but not set up well once again, as we get a tackle in the backfield once again. So it's now second and 16 year ball in the 17. They're a pass there to the left side, but he does not get enough, as he only gets, I believe, 7 yards on that one to make it 3rd and 8. So 3rd and 8 year ball on 25-yard line here, only less than 2 minutes left in the fourth. They deliver a pass right down the field, but it bobbles up in the air. They somehow get the catch for the first down. So unfortunate for us, as now 1st and 10 you're in the hurry-up offense, but they cannot deliver a pass in time as he lets go for an incompletion. So at this point in the game, though, they're just trying to go and get any amount of points on the field, even when it comes to even field goals, I guess. But now 3rd and 10 here, as they just bomb it down the field like it's disrupted by our defense, which makes it 4th down, 4th and 10, ball on the 46. As they're going for all here on 4th down, they're right down the field there for a catch, but they get dropped, and that means turnover on down. So effectively, the game is over, as our defense played so well today against the 49ers, but it's a 3rd and 7 year ball on the 43 here. It's going to drop back, find a man open there in for you for a first down, and that basically ices the game for us in this one. So a great catch there by Fourier, as we're just going to go down the field anyway for some points, because why not? It's a little rush there, Duke Johnson. Duke Johnson is rumbling and tumbling down the field up the middle for first down, as they call a timeout, their last timeout of the day. So it's 3rd and 8 to your ball to 7. Dillard rush there to Duke Johnson. Duke Johnson just plowing through the defense. They're trying to get a touchdown. Now 1st and goal here, ball in the 32 seconds left, as he runs in the end zone for another touchdown on the day. So want to add more points? We really don't care about sportsmanship, it's a video game. So we're leading 41-21, and this game is effectively over after Duke Johnson iced these 49ers. So it looks like Cole Colvin takes the first L against Keifer Paup here in his career, as the matchup is actually pretty good though. Cole Colvin didn't play that bad, but Keifer Paup just played better, as his offensive team is overall better. But now 3rd and 10 year ball on the 47, as the 49ers is trying to go for anything here, as it gets disrupted by our defense once again, as Grayson gets a hand on the ball. But now 4th and 10 year ball on the 47, deliver a rush there to Gatewood, but Gatewood gets nowhere as they get a turnover once again. And this game is finally over. No more points scored, as we're just going to go down there for the QB kneel to end off this game. So our defense played so well today, as we're finally in victory formation here with Vickers on the field, because you never know if Keifer Paup's going to somehow get injured, because he gets injured a lot during the end of the game, as we finally ended off this game here and now make it 3-2 here on the season for the Browns, as the 49ers are 2-3 in the season for them. So even this one, 41-21, huge game against the 49ers here. First W against Cole Colvin, between Cole Colvin and Keifer Paup. So anyway, guess on this episode off here. Make sure to subscribe, like, subscribe for more Browns Practice Mode. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.
This and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Cleveland.